I feel the need for speed, right? Woo!
I need some new clothes.
It's gotta be
inexpensive,
funky,
and definitely cool.
We're gonna go look around, try to find some cool phrases.
Baby, you are fly.
Smoothest, baddest, on the fly tip.
I'm here in Hollywood, California, in Robert Townsend's office.
So I've joined the party now, so stay tuned.
I need some new clothes. These old things just aren't
happening. I look like I'm
coming to see you from Avenger the Nerds.
Gotta buy something new. It's gotta be
inexpensive,
funky,
and definitely cool. Reversible, but it's polyester. It's kind of edgy. Not me. Do you have anything else? What do you think of this outfit here, huh? You like it? She's playing hard to get. I think it's time to change. I'm gonna make you love me. Yeah, I'm gonna make you love me before I'm
gone. I look like a tablecloth.
Y'all, I think this is it.
This
is me.
Why don't you pick up somebody your own size? Thank you.
Oh, Walter. I don't think I can take this much longer. I must be suffering from heat prostration.
I know, Leonard. You never can take the sun.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you one thing. It's better than being in that nasty, icky, salty, seaweedy water.
You're right. I hate the beach. Why do we keep coming here?
I don't know.
I'm so excited.
Babes? Kevin?
Hey, Trudy!
Hey, Candy!
Like, hi, Dino! Hi, Christy!
Well, dang it! Isn't this the most excellent diet of cats and rats?
Yeah, like just charging up the bod battery with some
solar!
But, Christy, your back is, like, totally crispy. Yeah, you're, like, really burned.
To earn it,
You gotta burn it!
Right, dude?
So, like, who made the Charlie Square Castle?
Not us!
But hey, yo, you gotta be a real dweeb or some actionist to be out here playing with Sam with this totally gnarly screamers beckoning for the chef, right?
Dude, I know! Can you believe it? The waves out there are like 15 feet high! So, like, are you waivers all waxed up for the big competition?
Negatory, babe! A competition is for
amateurs! Right. See, we don't surf on schedule. We surf on inspiration. Right, dude?
But, dude, we're counting on you. What? Yeah, like we told all the girls that you were going to win.
All of them?
Contestants, hit the waves!
Oh, no, I hate this.
Well, at least you can swim.
I can't believe you slapped my sunburn.
Well, I can't believe you broke the bucket.
Oh, don't forget to blow up your floaty. Come on.
You know what, Leonard?
What?
Man, I'm beginning to think the summer's never gonna end.
You're right.
I've always wanted a Jeep. But I also want a car that's sporty, long and sleek like a panther. So I guess what I really want is a sports car. Yeah, sports car. It has to be big enough to fit all my friends.
Fit the party.
Forget that. Purple.
It's gotta be purple. That's my favorite color.
Big wheels, white walls, license plate, maybe double D.
Change that to D twice. I need a big trunk to fit all my junk in there. A beach chair, a blanket, books, magazines. Definitely CD player. I also need a place to keep all my CDs. Speakers, they gotta be big, loud. Most of all, it's gotta drive fast. Even though I don't drive fast. But you know what I really want to do? Wish you could fly.
I wanted to fly.
I'm here in Hollywood, California, in Robert Townsend's office. Now, for those of you who don't know, Robert financed his first hit movie, Hollywood Shuffle, on his own credit card. Pretty amazing. Albert and I are going to hang out with him for a while, so let's see what's going on. Hey, guys.
What's up? How are you doing, Albert?
How's it going? Good. What are you guys talking about?
We're talking about I'm going to join the party. I'm going to be the sixth member of the party. Well, just tell me one of the lines of the song. Give me one of the lines of your song.
It goes, baby, baby, baby. With a soul. Baby.
That's it.
You got it. You got the part.
So I've joined the party now, so stay tuned.
So your first movie was Hollywood Shuffle, and supposedly you financed that with your own credit cards. How did you get the nerve to do that?
Hollywood Shuffle was my first film, and it came out of my frustration as an actor because I was going for all these different parts of like junkies and muggers and stuff. And so I said, I'm going to make my own movie. We started shooting the movie, and I didn't know how much a movie cost. And so I ran out of money like that. And then I said to myself, I could finish the film if I charged everything. And then I said, no, that's crazy. And everybody said, no, that's crazy. It's like, but as I began to really think it through, there's nothing you can't charge. And so that's how I did it. I was able to accomplish it.
So is this what you always wanted to do? Was this your ambition?
I wanted to be a basketball player, and I wasn't that good. So I would do voices on the bench, and I'd pretend like I was English, and I'd say, I wish the coach would put me in the game. You know, I got a good jump shot. You know, I can go to the basket. And so back then, I could do these voices. And then my friends were the ones that said, you should do something with your talent.
Robert, as a teenager, would you say that there was a lot of peer pressure get involved in drugs or to join a gang?
I guess I thought it was silly because why would someone want to be out of their mind for any little period of time doing drugs? Because drugs, it gives you a fake, you know, sense of woo. If somebody says, what gives you pleasure? What makes you happy? A three-point jump shot at the Y when I'm playing basketball makes me happy. Being behind the camera directing makes me happy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you have problems and something comes up and you do drugs, you get high for a second and then the drugs go away and the problems are still there. So it's not a solution. You know what I find is that people take life for granted. If you really have a dream, you have to be patient.
Mm-hmm.
And I think a lot of times people aren't patient. They want it now. Everything won't go as planned. The greatest things, sometimes there's a monkey wrench thrown into the plan. So I think that you have to understand that.
Robert, you're funny, you're successful, you're smart. I mean, you seem to have everything going for you. You seem to be almost the perfect role model for kids out there today. How would you describe yourself?
I don't know. I guess I would describe myself as just a hardworking guy who loves what he does and is a concerned filmmaker who loves people and wants to really, with his art, make a difference.